from America. How I became Muslim, it's a little different, it's unique. When I was in towards the end of my first year of college, there were a number of things that happened to me, a number of bad things, and they happened all at once. The doctor was telling me I might have health problems. There was a family member, my grandmother, she was also sick. But the two main things, you know, personally, that made me, that really stressed me out and made me sort of paranoid was something I was robbed. Like, I woke up one morning and all of my savings had been gone. And also something that happened to my brother. My brother had, you know, he basically had, he was with some guys and he witnessed a shootout where some guys were shooting. So these things were happening and it's making me question who is really my friend, who can I trust. It's making me really paranoid. I would try various books. I would, you know, think, you know, I would say this and then, you know, God can speak to you through anything. And I had been brought up a Christian. So I went to the Bible and I said, okay, God, please guide me and talk to me. And I opened it up and began to read at random. And what I read was more like history. It's more like a history book, or, you know, it didn't really touch me. I did that again later when I found an old copy of the Quran. And I would open up and, you know, just read at random. And the first thing I read was, this day I have shown favor upon you, perfected your path, and chose Islam as your religion.
اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا.
But you know, for 6 months, I really don't remember feeling pleasure. And then all of a sudden, it was like a relief. Like I could go, you know, I could breathe out and say, thank you. Because this is what I've been asking for. I've been saying, God, please help me and guide me. And there it was, you know, right there. I read the Quran from beginning to end over about 3 months. And slowly I just, you know, got better, got my senses back. When I first took Shahada, I just had taken Shahada by myself, you know, in the basement of my house, and I had read in a book that you should take Shahada, you know. And then after approximately 2 years, when I was in college, I found out that there was a masjid on the street that I lived. And so I went to visit, and there was a guy that I met there who became a really good friend of mine, who, you know, he started talking to me and said, you know, I haven't seen you here before, are you Muslim? And so I started talking, and he found out that, you know, I didn't know any Muslims, and that I hadn't taken Shahada with witnesses. And so he was saying, you know, oh, you should do that. After the prayer, you know, the imam says, you know, we have a guy, he wants to take Shahada. And so I go to the front, and there's, you know, maybe at least 100 people, maybe more. And, you know, they said, you know, repeat after me, and I said the Shahada, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah.
La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, madana rabbun siwa.